Good morning, welcome to Hardin County Commissioners Court. It is 10:00 a.m. on Tuesday, January the 16th, 2018. All members of the court are present and this meeting is called to order. Everyone will please rise for the invocation by Commissioner Pell, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Our dear Father, we thank you for being blessed this life, pray that you'd be with us now as we conduct the business of Hardin County. Give us wisdom, insight, and make good decisions for the people. Pray that you would be with those that are being affected by the weather today. Pray that you would just be with them, be with Chris as he will be traveling to Mississippi. Pray that you would be with our nation, be with President Trump as he leads this nation. Thank you for all the blessings you give us each day, these things we ask in Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner.
You're welcome.
Item number three, Glenda Austin, County Clerk, request approval of the January 2nd, 2018 regular meeting minutes as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts and a second by Commissioner Kirkendall, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number four, Deborah McWilliams, County Treasurer, requesting the court to cancel all registered claims from the January 2nd, 2018 regular meeting as presented. Good morning, Ms. McWilliams.
Good morning. The amount of the liability that I'm asking to be released of is $1,927,739.84.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts and a second by Commissioner Pell, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Number five, Deborah McWilliams, requesting approval of cash statement as presented.
In our general checking account, we have $1,920,595.34. In our investment account at Wells Fargo, we have $3,242,388.79. In textbook, we have $6,078,377.04 for a total cash funds of $11,241,361.17. I've also put on here the latest analysis statement. We ended the year in the negative $99.43, but I have talked to Josh Rodriguez and he will waive that. So we barely came in under the wire, but we think we've utilized our money.
Just for clarification, when you say that we come in the negative, that's how much we would have to pay in fees, right?
That's how much we would have to pay in fees.
Okay.
But he promised to drop the lowest 2 months, so.
Okay, so once he does that, then we'll be okay?
We're okay.
Won't cost us any fees for the year?
No fees for the year.
Right.
Also, on Friday afternoon, the tax office did bring in an additional $3 million that's not on this report. We always try to get this report ready and in your packets by noon on Friday, so we need a little bit more.
Good deal, thank you.
Move approved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Pell and a second by Commissioner Roberts, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously, thank you, Ms. McWilliams. Item number six, Angela Gore, County Auditor, requesting approval to pay county bills as presented. Good morning, Ms. Gore.
Good morning.
Good to have you back.
Thank you. Our expenditures for Commissioners Court on January the 16th are $476,820.62. Attached is a list of additional bills to be approved in the amount of $12,246.15. And if you'll look on that list of additional bills, you'll notice a note at the bottom. On December the 19th, a check request form was approved for payment to Hardin County Clerk in the amount of $360 for jury money on January the 11th, 2018. This jury was canceled, therefore the check was never issued. And the total expenditures and transfers for the period of January the 16th are $489,066.77. Your gross payroll for January the  18th will be $436,386.66. And the total transfers for that payroll, including retirement, insurance, and taxes, will be $711,818.98.
Move approved.
Second.
A motion by Commissioner Pell and a second by Commissioner Roberts to pay the county bills as presented, any discussion?
Yes.
Yes, sir, Commissioner Cooper.
Ms. Gore, I was talking with Commissioner Roberts earlier this morning before court in regards to some late payments that we've come across. have you noticed in your office, if we're paying a lot of?
If we're paying a lot of late fees?
Yeah.
I did notice some of the ones, that have been past due, that have just been now, the invoices have been sent over to pay. I've noticed those, but those are the only ones, but those are several months past due.
I'm thinking that, I didn't get it from, Commissioner Roberts, but I'm thinking my secretary told me the ones that we had, they didn't actually charge it to us, so we didn't have to pay it. I would be, interested to know that if we have to, pay any, looking into having court every Tuesday so we can get these bills paid.
Yes, sir, you will have to pay late fees if there's late fees attached to an invoice. Do you know what vendors you're speaking of?
No, I really don't. It just happened to come up in conversation. I haven't looked particularly. I know she had, told me there was a couple, I think Energy maybe, and maybe the, gas people, I don't remember. It's electrical bills and things like that that we're mostly, having, and I would assume that it's only pertaining to road and bridge and not the rest of the county, so.
We're including a lot of energy bills on this list of additional bills. If we're getting them in, as a matter of fact, at 8:30 this morning, I added another one, because I got it this morning on this list. So if we get them before court, we put them on the list, so.
Is this something new with the late fees because of the way that we're paying the bills differently, as of starting in October? Is this something that we've had going on for a while with the late fees that are coming up?
We haven't had it, a lot of it in the past. I'll have to look at what he's referring to.
I try to stay on top of it, in my precinct, and I'm sure the other commissioners have as well, but I think, this has all started since.
Well, that's what I'd like to know. If it's because of that, and we need to start meeting weekly, then we need to probably talk about doing that, if that's an issue. But when you and I talked when we started this, you said as long as they got to you on time, you'd put them on this list and they'd be paid.
So I didn't realize that we weren't getting them in time to pay them, in these commissioners.
Sometimes the due dates on some of those things, by the time they mail them out to us and then we get them, the due date's like 5 to 10 days later. I mean, they almost want an immediate turnaround on payment, so.
I know the Verizon bill's that way. I think when we get it, it's usually due about seven or eight days after we receive it.
Yeah.
But, we've been presenting that to Angela as soon as it comes in so that it gets on this list if it's not ready for the regular, list that we get from the treasurer.
We noticed an issue with three invoices last month, but we found a discrepancy too on the address to be mailed to, BB and in your office. It was different, but they got that reconciled. And then we're still doing mini courts, right? I mean, we can.
Well, no, this is what we stopped. We stopped the mini courts because.
Well, that's what I thought.
It was judged to be illegal.
Yeah, well, it's like Commissioner Cooper was saying, you know, we might have to, if that's gonna be the case on the way that the bills roll, we may have to have just a brief meeting on Tuesdays, you know, every other Tuesday, not normal meeting, but a brief meeting on that Tuesday to approve the bills to be paid.
Well, you were discussing, about mailing the bills, getting to you and through the mail. You may can contact your vendors and ask them to email you an invoice.
Yeah.
And you would get it faster.
That's what we did with the Verizon bill. They emailed that to Misty now. And, I think we also, I think Alicia had contacted Energy on a couple of accounts to change the due date so that we got them in time to get them paid. But whatever we need to do, I don't want to pay any late fees.
And is there any way?
It's not just the utility bills, though, that we have. We have like, where we buy materials or stuff. I saw Martin Marietta this morning and it had already been paid, but we were already being billed again for it. We've seen a few of them that come across like that where we don't repay them. We just, you know, I either get Melanie to call the people and tell them it's been vouchered and it's going to be paid. We have been seeing some of those.
Any way the court can do a resolution if it's in the budget to just give that authority, like if you have to pay, like what a mini court was, since it's already been approved in the budget, especially if they're approved vendors, you know, if you have a phone bill, gas bill, you buy materials, obviously they've bid it on that. We can't do a resolution and avoid having to meet every Tuesday.
No, sir, I think that was the issue that we discussed because you gave the county judge the authority to pay those bills on mini courts, and then the attorney general came through and said that was an illegal procedure, that the commissioner's court needed to approve all bills, including payroll.
Well, God bless him.
Yes, sir.
And that again, And I definitely understand it, and I'm all for what we're doing now, but that again is just an attorney general's opinion. We could keep doing what we're doing. Or what we have been doing. Y'all recommended from a conference that y'all went to not to do that because the rest of the state was doing that, but there's nothing on statute that says we can't. It's just an attorney general's opinion.
It puts me at a personal liability, is where if we don't follow the law and what the attorney general recommends as their interpretation of the law.
Well, I think we should. I was just bringing that point out.
What it actually does is it comes back that any check I release without your authority, I am personally responsible for that check. So.
And she says she just didn't have the money to pay.
You need a pretty good raise for that.
We pay payroll 1 week without approval.
I suggest that the judge and Angela and all the parties look at it and see what this court needs to do.
Thank you.
We'll do that. Thank you, Commissioner.
Yes.
Any other discussion on item number six? That was a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Roberts. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number seven, Chief Monica Kelly, Juvenile Probation Department. This item, the chief has asked me to postpone, so if we could have a motion to table item number seven. Ms. Calloway could not be here today, and she'll come at the next meeting.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number eight, adoption of resolution 1-18, supporting the creation of the Southeast Texas Disaster Recovery Team and appointing three executive board members to serve until December the 31st, 2019.
Move to approve.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall and a second by Commissioner Cooper to approve and adopt resolution 1-18. Just as a quick discussion on this item, this will support the creation of a long-term recovery group in Southeast Texas in the region. And it appoints the three following board members to serve until December 31st, 2019. And that's Pastor Arthur Smith, who's here with us today. Also, Mr. Kevin Johnson, who's with the Crestwood Baptist Church between Lumberton and Coons. And Ms. Belinda Trest in Sour Lake with Cat Construction. They've all three agreed to serve as board members. That'll be the executive board. There'll be a committee in each county that works with that executive board, and that's to rebuild and help people who have unmet needs from the disaster in August of 2017, Hurricane Harvey. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. And thank you very much, Pastor, for agreeing to serve on that. He has actually already attended some training in Austin back in December, I believe it was, on how a long-term recovery group works, and that will help us when we go to start asking for money from the Red Cross and other national organizations. They're only going to give money to groups such as that long-term recovery group. Mm-hmm. And so this is going to be a big help for all of the region. We thank you all very much. Item number nine, Carl Marshall with the Southeast Texas Regional Planning Commission, requesting approval of the 2018 Hardin County Atlas. And we have those here in front of us today.
Yes.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning. That's the 2018 book we cover this year with the visitor center. Signs prettier than the building, so. But that's basically the draft copies that were presented last court.
Yes, sir.
Those, there were no changes, so that could act as your sixth book for the.
Good deal.
Move we approve.
Second.
A motion by Commissioner Pelt to approve and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? Carl, we appreciate all that you do for us.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much, sir. Very helpful.
Thank you.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 10, acceptance of Hardin County Appraisal District election results for fiscal year 2018. Do we have those in our packets?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll just stuck to my other paper.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 11, Chief Monica Kelly, discussion and possible action regarding the request for approval of outside detention contracts with Chambers, Jasper, Liberty, Orange, and Tyler counties.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Roberts. This is just a renewal?
Yes, sir.
So there's no change to the contracts other than just the dates?
Correct. And I think our county attorney reviewed that last year.
Okay.
So they're the same contracts.
Very good. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Thank you, Monica. Item number 12, Commissioner Ken Felt, Precinct 3, discussion and possible action to approve abandonment of certain roadways in Western Townsite Company subdivision located in Sour Lake and in Richard Rogers subdivision also located in Sour Lake. This was the item we had on our public hearing this morning at 9:30.
Yes,
Commissioner Felt.
Judge, Court, we had the public hearing. There was no one in the public here that had any opposition to this, and therefore I move that we do abandon certain roadways in Western Townsite Company subdivision located in Sour Lake, Grayburg area, and in Richard Rogers subdivision located in Sour Lake, Grayburg area.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Felt and a second by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 13, Commissioner L.W. Cooper, permission to purchase a 575-gallon tank asphalt distributor trailer with sprayer.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall and a second by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item 14, Misty Sims, purchasing agent, permission to appoint a committee to evaluate proposals from consultants to apply for the fiscal year 2018 hazard mitigation grant program regarding possible buyouts.
So moved.
Second.
Do we have a list of those committee members?
And I do check with each one, Judge Brewer, Monica Kelly, and Laura Pate.
And you made the motion, Commissioner Kirkendall?
Yes, sir.
And have a second by Commissioner Roberts. Is that right?
Yes.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion to appoint the committee passes unanimously. And you'll notify them? All right, thank you, ma'am. Item number 15, Misty Sims, permission to solicit bids through Renee Bates online auction for sale of surplus equipment, computers. Hard drives have been removed from the computers, computer paper, and other miscellaneous items.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Felt and a second by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. That's going to clean up all that area back there in the courtroom. Thank you. Item number 16, discussion only of any other item that's not on the agenda without taking action. I just wanted to bring up one quick item here. The Disaster Recovery Center, the FEMA and State Disaster Recovery Center, the only one located, or the closest one located to our citizens is in Beaumont. It was at the Gateway Shopping Center, but January the 2nd, it moved right around the corner. And I didn't bring the address in here with me, but it's the old Parker Uniforms building. And if anybody needs that address, let me know. I'll be glad to get it to you. But anybody who's been denied FEMA assistance who feels like they qualify, I recommend that they go there in person. I've talked to several citizens who've had good luck going down there when it was at the Gateway Shopping Center. There's several people there with FEMA, SBA, and other representatives there who have been very helpful. So I just want to recommend that if y'all could help get the word out. If somebody has an issue, rather than getting online or sending it in by mail, if they'll go in person, there's been a little better success rate with people applying for and appealing their denial letters with FEMA. Anybody who needs temporary housing, they have to apply for that through FEMA. The deadline was November 30th, but if anybody missed the deadline and has a good reason, they can just write a letter. FEMA will let them go ahead and apply. One more thing, the group that we talked about earlier that the pastor's going to be a part of, if somebody has an unmet need and they have not applied for FEMA assistance or an SBA loan, they're not going to qualify for assistance from the long-term recovery group either. So that's all regulations that's set up by FEMA, and we have to follow that. So just help us continue to get that word out to the citizens who are suffering. I know that we have about 323 who need temporary housing, and I think as of last Friday, there was 166 that are in, so we're about halfway there. And I hope we haven't missed anybody, but if we have, I'd like for them to contact me, or they can also contact Michelle Brewer. And we'll be glad to try to do our best to get them the help that they need. Does anybody have anything further?
Move adjourned.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Felt and a second by Commissioner Kirkendall. We are adjourned.
Appreciate you, Judge.
Yes, sir. Got a stack.